Florence Kelly's biographer said, "Her face was like a stone afterwards." The revolution in work and in the workplace did indeed come for many, if not for everyone, and it created unimagined opportunities for making even more money for the rich, the privileged, skilled. Even the worldwide poor had the chance to benefit. Almost overnight, it seemed, there was worldwide access to literacy, to the acquisition of technical training. No longer would elite educational institutions have a monopoly in science or technical training or in access to libraries and the literature of the world or to the learning of English. It wasn't the revolution that Florence Kelly or Henry Demarest Lloyd or Clarence Darrow or Friedrich Engels expected, but it is a revolution, and of work, and of the workplace. Much of her time in New York, Florence Kelly lived at the Henry Street Settlement House, a place like Hull House, but not the center of a national and international community, or perhaps the times had simply changed. The National Consumers League became her community. Florence Kelly opposed the Equal Rights Amendment in the 1920s after decades of devoting herself to advocating for women's political suffrage and political participation. New Delhi, January 12, 2011. "The people who live here call this cold, the middle 50s. It is damp." From the Chicago perspective of a dreary, endless, bone-chilling winter, it is warm in India, 20 degrees above freezing. The air is gray, and the greasy smog, the particulate industrial exhalations, can be felt immediately in the lungs, on your face, in the hair. It leaves a slime. Everyone complains about it, and everyone says that someone must do something about it.